What are the answer?
Hey everybody, this is Team One, also known as the A Team. So my name is Rocky, and this is the great group that we had over here. We were talking about heritage. Some of the things that we could do to work on heritage is enriching our local dance by teaching programs in colleges. Art history. We found that enriching art history in colleges also would be a good thing to do, because we found that, what did we find? That there wasn't enough art, is that right? There wasn't enough art and not enough going history that went all the way around to the later parts of adulthood and early adulthood in college. It was just mainly in elementary. Yeah, I know, guys, I know. Alpha team, move. Go.
Just one light, not two lights.
Let's see, and also, when I think of, when I and my team, there's no I in team. There you go. let's see, so, in culture, you always think of fashion. We can see that here all around us, we see fashion. A good thing to do is to spread that. We can spread that to different globes about Goan culture through fashion shows. We can work on it locally first, and then try to enrich it with the Goa Sudok, which we thought about making like a forum on the Goan Sudarab website, where all the youth from all over the world can just talk about different topics. Kind of like, you know, on Facebook where you have the little drop-down thing where you can talk to different people. But have you guys ever been on forums where you actually talk about subjects? So for example, if I wanted to talk about environmental issues, and Sheila over here wanted to reiterate on that and talk about what kind of environmental issues. I thought that would be a pretty good topic. So forums on the Goa Sudarab website would be pretty good. Let's see. Sheila, you want to help me read this? My throat's getting a little dry. Women right here. I'll just keep going. So, women, we found out that one of the topics was women. It's not safe for young women to go out in public late at night. One of the ways we could figure that out to solve it is by setting new laws. Setting new laws that will help and yeah, we got one more minute. Also, self-protection. Like, think about Goan girls training late at night and doing, like, martial arts or carrying, like, pepper spray in their purses. It sounds funny, but it allows you to actually go out in public. And it's one way to solve it, because we found that one of my suggestions was more police. But then we had the Goan youth girls saying that the police are just corrupt around here. I hope there's none of them watching, but listening. But they're corrupt around here and they don't help out. So how are you gonna help yourself? You can help yourself by doing self-defense, carrying just a tiny bottle of pepper spray and just helping yourself like that. I thought that would be really good. I think that's about it. That's all we got.
So as you get off, you say your first name.
This way. First name as you get up. So we know who you are. Yeah. And you come quick.
Jason.
Loudly. Steven.
Mega.
Sneha.
Philomena.
Rajoti.
Sheila.
Divya.
Manjusha.
Divya.
Joycey.
Saira.
Rohini.
Rifa.
Okay, good. So next group, three minutes. And give your summary page to Praveen. Okay, Steven, you have the summary page, give it to Steven so he can summarize it. Okay, who's the spokesperson?
Hello, my name is Bruce, and I would speak on behalf of my group here. Okay, as regards heritage, what I believe is we should first become aware of what our heritage is. So what I was suggesting in our group as well, that when I am from Margaon, and suppose if I take up, we should take up one thing at a time, like if I take up churches, I should know what is the history of our, suppose if I take Holy Spirit Church, just to give an example. Now, how many of you all know that the present Holy Spirit Church is not the original church? It is the fourth one there. Three times it was destroyed, twice by Adil Shah of Bijapur, and the third time it caught fire, and then that is the fourth one that is there. So how many of us know among ourselves here? So what I was suggesting is, first our group becomes conscious about it, and we do some research and create write-ups and send to each one, probably. We put it up on our website, and that's how we first get informed about it. Is that right? Okay. And that would, it's just to tell you about, that's the heritage side. Okay? You take up one, maybe in a month we take up about the churches. Okay? Just do a little research. We do not, I don't expect anyone. Yeah, but how many of us really read, sir, unless we mail it through someone and then... Yeah, but, you know, other than Facebook and Twitter, nothing happens. Okay, and then we have about women. First, creating awareness in our colleges itself. Educate the men there as how to respect a woman. And then also what I was suggesting to our group and the girls being here is the women also should learn how to respect themselves. Because, you know, this was as quoted by an Australian government there. I would just like to tell you. He said, if you throw a piece of meat in your own courtyard, how many dogs would not snatch it? Correct? He said, so women also should learn how to protect themselves. So what I would suggest is, you know, you should protect yourself and at least carry, as my friend Steven said, a spray in your bag. This is what my friends in Bangalore do as well. I see them always carrying a pepper spray in their bags, you know. And then, what do you say, learn martial arts. What is there? Someday or the other it will help. Others you can teach your children. Yeah, and already also you'll be on the slimmer side as well. And then I was, also we get along with the women organization and conduct various, awareness campaigns with them. Now suppose, now there was the Delhi gang rape case. How many in Margaon really contributed to this, though we had Bailan, so I quote a very good self group here? None of us. So one, the Goa Sudharup should say that when any violation takes place against any woman, we immediately come together and fight for a cause. And that too with a group that has already manifested its power. So that we also tomorrow, first today with them and then tomorrow independently. Entrepreneur. No, I would like to give another chance because she's doing a project work in entrepreneurship.
So, I have all youths over here, so we know better, okay? See, we youths, we have lots of ideas. Okay, more of if you are doing business, if you are doing studies in business, we usually want to start our business, right? But we do have an idea, but we don't have how to do it. Means we don't know. We just know that we want to do it. We want to do something. But for that reason, y'all should have some idea of how to do it. And for that purpose, education, I mean, like incubation centers are set up for the entrepreneurs. So for the youths who want to start a business, so they should go for, means they should, yeah, they should go to the incubation centers and get themselves educated how they should start their business so that they don't end up in doing something which is, means later on they will fall in some troubles, like, you know. Yeah, and in spite of that, the incubation centers not only provide them information how to do their business, but they also provide services, like they provide them financial assistance, financial help, and helps regarding various things. They provide them courses also, you know, they provide them courses so that they get educated in what they want to do. But the youths are not really aware about it. No, you know, now see in our college only, most of the people are, they say that they want to do business, but they don't know how to do the business, and they don't know about the incubation centers also. So it's necessary that in Goa we should promote incubation centers. Means incubation centers should come out, and more incubation centers should be set up, because if students will not, then how will they come and approach their incubation centers? So firstly, we should first bring more and more incubation centers, and youths should try to find out, means not only they should go to through the internet, they should try to find out different ways how they can get the information, and then they should start a business. Having a full information and then starting a business is better than knowing nothing and starting a business.
No, one second, yeah. Okay. The best way to bring all this out among, if we are bringing it out among people, would be doing street plays, you know, because our actions speak louder than words. Whenever we perform anything, that would give a clear message to others. So once in a way, it is good to take up like writing a street play on a culture of Goa, or writing street play on women, taking up different issues. So when you really act, you gather a crowd. Otherwise, if you just speak here, people just give deaf ears. But if you like to act and give the message to others, then you can really draw thousands and create awareness among them. Thank you.
Good. So, say your name as you get up.
Bruce Fernandez from Kare Law College.
Okay, I'm Goran Marga.
I'm Ashutosh Marga.
Nikhil.
Alicia from MES.
Shabnam from MES.
I'm Manisha.
Rashmita from KPM.
Utkarsha.
Shama from MES.
Ninashka.
Stephanie.
Cassandra.
Alex.
Shiva.
Spokesperson.
A very good morning to everyone. This is group 3, and the motto of our group is Kadam chota hai par asar bada hoga, which means a small change can make a big difference. Therefore, the points which we will tell you all are on a very small level, but we believe it will make a big difference. For women's issue, we would say that telling girls not to go out, that won't work out. We don't want sympathy. We don't want that we should get reserved seats in the train or in the bus. We want to stand up for our rights. It is only then we will be treated equally. There should be gender equity. We should be treated equal. The law should be made strict. We cannot completely depend on the law, but it is high time where we take a decision, and the law should be made strict, and therefore the criminals should be also punished in the same manner. For heritage, we feel that heritage just does not mean preserving your monuments. Heritage starts at home itself. Like, for example, preserving your traditional customs at home, preserving the utensils that you use, perhaps made of coconut. Then you should save the mountains. That is also preserving your heritage. We mean that you should stop mining. For business, we would say that it is time that you should use your creative mind, your creative thinking. You should recognize and appreciate the talent that you have in yourself. A small talent that you have can be a reason for your earning. It can be any small job. Like we say in college campus, we can go grow trees. Like Kepe College is doing that. They grow bananas in their college and then they sell it. So it is a small way of earning, but it does make a big difference. Then for the status of Goa, we cannot actually decide the status of Goa, but we should be conscious of what we do. Today we are crying that, yeah, there's no land left for us. But when people from Delhi come, they offer us more money. The people in greed end up selling their land and later they cry that there's nothing left for us. It is your conscience that should tell you that you must not sell it because it is yours and you cannot give it to someone else, and especially not for the greed of money. Thank you. Deepika.
Savya.
Tania.
Afia.
Diksha.
Karishma.
Saina.
Hiram.
Jyoti.
Shweta.
Selma.
Akshya.
Eva.
Rekha.
This is Josephine from Kepping College.
Thank you. That was the all women's group. Who's the spokesperson? Spokesperson. Oh, the spokesperson is the youngest.
No, I'm only saying what the
spokesperson. Okay, Liam, how
do you? Okay.
So, our group has decided to speak on three of the major issues in Goa, which is heritage, environmental issues, with including mining, and the safety of women.
You cannot hide. No hiding. All in the front. Front of the chairs.
I'm taking a picture.
No hiding.
You can come near the screen. You can come in front of the screen. Look, that's a fight on the
stage. Good morning, people. First, we'll be speaking on heritage. Basically, heritage, we know the things are there on the site, websites, they are in the books, but who goes to read them? People are focused on various other things like social networking, etc. Then why not get these things at the places where we want them to? So, like basically, our group, we were thinking of preparation of documentaries, small videos, movies, etc. So that they can be posted on the social networking sites, and then they can be presented at various schooling levels, college levels, so that people generate interest. The basic reason why people don't know about these things because they don't have any interest in this. We can, by making documentaries, we can generate interest among the people so that they go refer to these things, they get interested, they know about these things, and that is how we can get the support for the Archaeological Survey of India. We can so that they approve the various places, heritage sites. Also, by having signing campaigns wherever we go, wherever we present these things, we can have signing campaigns so that we can present these signatures to the Archaeological Survey of India, so that they know that these heritage sites are important. So next speaker.
I don't want that. Fine. Our second topic is environmental issues related to mining. See, we are not discussing here about issues, but it's an action plan. And mining is something is really difficult to put it in 1 minute. We cannot put it. But thing is that, see, there are three topics. There are three issues in mining. One is mines are stopped or banned in Goa. 100% stopped. So there are three issues. One is environmental issues. Second one is mining, because there is a lack of extraction, lack of ore, and third is economic crisis. Now, we are just putting one question in the audience. Mining as a backbone of Goa, just a question mark. You all think whether it is. Like, see, there were 105 mines in Goa and all are stopped now. So how far it is advantage, how far it is better for Goa? It's It's on you. Now, see, mining today or tomorrow, it was supposed to stop. So it is unexpectedly stopped. The thing is that now we should look for option. Now, what is the option? Government of Goa is investing hundreds of crores in agriculture. So our group, what we are discussing, what we have thought is that, now let's forget about what has happened. Now, let's not wait until mining gets started. Let's talk about agriculture and all these schemes which are there. One best example I'll give you, there are schemes like if you are buying a cattle of 1 lakh, there's a subsidy, 90% subsidy. You don't have to pay 90,000, you just have to repay 10,000. So these are some of the golden opportunities. These are some of the subsidies which are there. So what we are thinking is that we'll just compile this and we'll try to make awareness about these issues. And ultimately, the last one, what I was before she takes over, what I want to suggest is that, see, we have met for youth convention, and let's form one action group. Like, not for one day, not for one month. Let's form one group. Sir, Yvonne is there, Jayesh is there. So if tomorrow we need youth, we need something to do, let Jayesh will call once and then let's meet together and we'll do something. So this will be a action group, you know, and from US there are people, here we'll, from here we will work and from they will work and then we can link. So that is my suggestion.
Thank you, sir. The last but not the least issue we have taken up is regarding the safety of women. One must be made aware of all the issues regarding women at school level, but rather home level. But what happens is parents themselves feel shy to speak to their children what's going on around them. So we have thought of coming up with workshops for parents as well as kids at school levels. We could also start up a self-defense program for women, be it at school, college, or even working place, because safety of women has become an important issue in today's world. Another thing we have thought of is asking the government to provide transport just for women, because we have seen that there's no one follows women reservation in the bus. So it would be better if there's transport just for women, and especially after, you know, the in the late hours, during maybe after 10 or so. Also, free